Hi everyone and welcome back. So in previous videos I was covering these small quiz like Angular quiz, JavaScript quiz. In this video I'm covering one React quiz. So why I'm putting these small quiz is just to make it more interesting, because I'm covering most of these interview questions which are theoretical and lengthy. So it will just help you to go through quickly these different quizzes. So let's start with this. So what does the webpack commands do? Webpack is actually a bundler. It does a lot of things like bundling, transpiling, all those things it does. So it is doing both the things. Webpack dev server also helps you to create a server for launching your application. What are the advantages of React.js? I mean, React.js is a Vue, it's a framework, lightweight framework to create your UI layer, UI components. React can be used at the client side and server side. That is correct. You can use Next.js for writing a server side rendered application. So it is all of these. Okay. Now, which of the following API is a must for every React.js component? You have to render something. I mean, if you are writing a functional component, you still will skip writing constructor. But render, I'm not talking about particular render method, but your component should return some JSX. You can still return null, empty array or something. So render is appropriate if we compare all these things. Okay, render is also not appropriate because in functional component, you are not writing render method. You are just returning a JSX. But render is most appropriate out of these. So I'm choosing this. Okay, how can you access the state of a component from inside a member function? This dot state, because this dot state and this dot props, this is how you access props and state. This dot get state not a method, current state not a method, this dot state. Okay, the lifecycle methods of a component falls under following categories. You might have heard about this. There is a mount phase, there is update phase, and there is an unmount phase. So that this is also called initialization. Initialization, update, and unmount. So first will be appropriate answer. Now in the component lifecycle, which one is executed before rendering? So there are different set of lifecycle methods. One which talks about 15.x React version and one which is the latest. Component will mount is there in 15.x, which execute before your render method executes. So that looks appropriate because these lifecycle methods are pointing to the older lifecycle set of methods. Okay, which of the following method defines default value and property using props? So we have a get default props to initialize the default props. Some in components you also do the prop type validations, and then you can also set the default props if that is not coming from the parent component. Get default props should be the right one. Now, which of the following mounting methods are invoked before the component is inserted in the DOM? So it's talking about render method, right? So there is a get initial state or component will mount, get initial state component. So component did mount and did update are executed after render function. So get initial state and component will mount. And these are basic questions, so I'm not adding any explanation to these. What is the difference between constructor and get initial state? Get initial state and get initial state and constructor. So let's try to see this. You should initialize the state of a constructor. So when you are writing ES6 class, you use constructors. If you are writing ES5 code for React components, which we are not using right now, but we used to write get initial state in the ES5. Now coming to the next, can you force a component to render without calling set state? Yes, there is the force update method, so we can use that to set the state without using set state method. What is the difference between super and super props in React using ES6 class? So in ES6 class, if you want to access this dot props, then you must call the parent class constructor by passing the props when you want to access this dot props. So that is the correct one. Let me see. We will relook into this. Let me just see what was that. Outside, yeah, okay, yeah. This is A and B both, because outside constructor both will display the same value for this dot props. Okay, to the next one. how to loop inside JSX. So you can use error.prototype.map. You can still use for each, but you have to do a tweak, because error.prototype.map, what it will give you, it will give you an array of JSX, and JSX can render an array of indexes, right? If you have array and each array index has a JSX, like some DOM nodes, you can render it. So the appropriate one is the array.prototype.map method you can use to render it. What is the difference between React and React DOM? So we use React and React DOM APIs. React to create a component, React DOM.render to mount the component on some DOM node, right? So React package contains create element, component, and React children, and other helper methods related to the component classes. That is correct. React DOM package contains a React DOM.render. So this is also correct. So it looks like there are multiple options. Yes, this is also correct. So all of the above. Okay, is it possible to use React without rendering HTML? That is correct. I mean, you can just return false, null, or empty array. So this is possible only in 16.x. I mean, earlier you will not be able to do this. So this is correct, all of the above. Considering that you are using latest version of React, why you can't update props in React? Props can be updated in the child component. First of all, props are immutable, that you might already aware if you are doing React. So React is this, the React philosophy is that props should be immutable. They are just for data passing between components. This is pretty much easier because I didn't make these questions more complex. So that's all we have for React quiz. We'll keep pushing these complex, very complex quiz throughout these full stack interview questions about Angular, React, Vue.js, Node.js, or vanilla JavaScript.